Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Off Campus. Before going into the video, kindly subscribe our channel Off Campus and click on the bell icon. You will receive notifications. Okay, recently we have seen in differential equations and solved many problems in differential equations. In this video also we are going to see type 2 singular integral. Previously we have seen what is the type 1 complete integral. There is no way for this type. If you haven't seen those videos still, kindly check with the playlist. Okay, then only you can understand the type 2. Okay, type 2 will be in the form of f of p comma q equal to 0. So we have derived complete solution for this type. Then for this type f of p comma q, and one more point, f of p comma q equal to 0, in this type there is no singular integral. Okay, there is no singular integral for this type form, for this form f of p comma q equal to 0. So only complete integral. Okay, then we will see the singular integral for type 2. Type 2 will be we know that previously we have seen type 1 it will be a function of p and q alone. Okay, then what will here type 2 is known as Clairaut's form. It is also called as Clairaut's form. See, it is in the form of z equal to px plus qy plus function of pq. In type 1, only function of pq alone. So in this Clairaut's form, this is type 2. So kindly watch those videos. Okay, type 1 video, then only you can continue this video. Okay, then z equal to px plus qy plus f of function of pq. Then what is the complete integral? Complete integral is nothing but z equal to ax plus by plus f of a comma b. See, substitute p equal to a and q equal to b. This is the complete integral. If the given problem is given in Clairaut's form, which means that z equal to px plus qy plus f of p comma q, we know that we should know that is type 2. Okay, then what we know, that what is the complete integral? Z equal to ax plus by plus function of a comma b, substitute p equal to a and q equal to b. This is the complete integral or complete solution. Then complete integral, integral or solution are the same one. Okay, then how to find the singular integral or singular solution? Just partially differentiate this equation with respect to a and equate to 0. Find out one constant, then dou z by dou b, then again partially differentiate with respect to a and b. Okay, partially differentiate with respect to a and b and equate to 0, then find out the value for sum a and b, and then substitute in this equation z. Okay, this is the method to solve. We'll see some example problems how to solve this type of problem. See, what is given in the first question? What is given? The singular integral. See, what is given? The singular integral of z equal to px plus qy plus pq is. Four different options are given. What we need to find out? So, if it is in the form of z equal to px plus, it is in the form of z equal to px plus qy plus function of p comma q, right? Function of p comma q. What is this? This is Clairaut's form, right? Clairaut's form type 2. This is type 2. See, okay? Then what we need to do? Then therefore, what is the complete integral? Complete integral is nothing but z is equal to ax plus by plus function of a comma b. So this is the complete integral. So substitute a in this equation, given equation, what is that? Z equal to px plus qy plus pq. Substitute p equal to a and q equal to b. What we get? This is the ax plus by plus ab. So this is the complete solution for this problem. See, then what we need to do, what is the third, we first we need to identify the type. This is the function of px plus qy and function of pq. So this is type 2. So for that types 2, it is in the Clairaut's form. So then what is the complete integral? So substitute a equal to b equal to a and q equal to b in that equation. This is the complete integral. Then we need to find the singular integral. To find singular integral, how to find the singular integral? Integral dou z by dou a equal to 0, then dou z by dou b equal to 0. So what is mean that from this equation, say it is equation 1 or this is equation 2. So equation 1, equation 2 partially differentiate with respect to a. So what we will get, dou z by dou a equal to a, with respect to a we will get x, this term will get 0. By differentiating a b, what we will get, x plus b equal to 0. So what is b here? B is nothing but minus x. Okay, then what we need to do to find singular and dou z by dou a equal dou z by dou b and then equal to 0. So dou z by dou b equal to 0, which means that from this equation, what is dou z by dou b? Partially differentiating with respect to b. So this term won't come. Okay, then for this, y plus a equal to 0, then what is a? Equal to minus y. So we know the value of b and value of a. So substitute in this equation. So z is equal to what is a? Minus y into x plus b. B is nothing but minus x into y again, plus ab. Ab is minus into minus plus simply plus xy. So minus xy here, also minus xy plus xy, right? Xy plus xy minus xy get cancelled. So minus xy equal to z. So see, this is the singular integral or singular solution for this problem. Z equal to minus xy. See which one? Option 4, z equal to minus xy is the right option for this problem. I will tell you again to find out the singular integral. How to find out the singular? See guys, type 1. Kindly watch. I am telling you again and again. Kindly watch type 1 problem. Previous videos. Then only you can understand. Kindly check with the playlist. And also I will give the in the cards which is running above the video. Okay. Then to find out the singular, see the first we need to identify the type. So z equal to px plus qy plus pq. So it is in the form of z equal to px plus qy plus function of pq. This is type 2. This is also known as Clairaut's form. So what is the complete integral for this, or complete solution? Z equal to ax plus by plus function of ab, which means that put p equal to a and q equal to b. Okay, given equation is z equal to px plus y, px plus qy plus pq, the given problem, right? Then we need to substitute p equal to a and q equal to b in that equation. Then we need to find out the singular integral. Singular integral, how to find the singular integral? Differentiate this equation partially with respect to a and b and equate to 0 and find out the constant for find out the value of a and b and substitute these values in that equation, we will get the singular solution. Okay, then we'll solve a few problems in this type. See, to the singular integral of 1 minus x into p plus 2 minus y into q equal to 3 minus z is, 4 different options are given. What is the first we need to identify the type. So it is px plus qy and function of pq only. Okay, see, we'll see. So this is the given problem, 1 minus x into p, 2 minus y into q equal to 3 minus z. Okay, this is the given problem. Then multiply inside p minus px, 2q minus qy, 3 minus z. Okay, then minus px, I am just rearranging, minus qy plus p plus 2q minus 3 equal to minus z. And then multiply by minus sign. So z, take this into left hand side, so minus sign. So px plus qy plus this constant 3 minus p minus 2q, right? Are we clear, right? Just cross multiply inside and just rearranging px plus qy and function of pq, z equal to in this form. This is what is this px plus qy plus 3 minus p, sorry, plus function of pq. So what is this? This is Clairaut's form, right? This is Clairaut's form, okay? Then what is, therefore, what is the complete integral or complete solution? Z equal to ax plus by plus function of a comma b, which means that in that equation, see, it is a equation 1, substitute p equal to a and q equal to b. So what we will get? We will get the complete solution. Z equal to ax plus by plus 3 minus a minus 2b, right? Say it is a equation 2. I am checking again, ax plus by plus 3 minus a minus 2b. So this is the equation, right? So to find singular integral, what we need to do? To find singular integral, what is the third step? Partially differentiate with respect to a and b in equation 2 and equate to 0 and find out the value of a and b or whatever will come and substitute this in this equation, okay? So dou z by dou a, partially differentiating with respect to a, dou z by dou a is nothing but x, okay? This term won't to come, this is also constant, it is respect to y only, so this won't come, this is also constant, minus a, so minus 1, this is also constant, it gets 0, so x minus 1 equal to 0, so x equal to 1, say, then dou z by dou b, find out this partially differentiate with respect to b and equate to 0. So b, this term won't come, b is nothing but y, this won't come and minus 2, right? Y minus 2 equal to 0, then what is y? Y equal to 2. Then what we need to do, what we need to do in this equation, we know that a equal to, so I am writing here z equal to, right? This equation na, z equal to ax plus by plus 3 minus a to b, substitute x equal to 1 and y equal to 2 in that equation. What we will get? X equal to 2. X equal to 2, what we will get? A plus, see, x equal to 1, sorry, a plus b, y equal to 2. Plus 2b plus 3 minus a minus 2b, right? Substitute x equal to 1 and y equal to 2 in that equation. What we will get? See, plus a minus a get cancelled, 2b minus 2b get cancelled. What we will get? Z equal to 3. So this is the singular integral for this problem, z equal to 3. So option C is the right option. Okay, we'll solve one more problem in this type. We'll see the singular solution of z equal to px plus qy plus p square minus q square. So what is given? Z equal to px plus qy, plus p square minus q square. So what is this step? This is type 2, right? Type 2. This is Clairaut's form. How it be? Z equal to px plus qy plus function of pq equal to type 2. This is Clairaut's form. Then what is the second step? First we need to identify the type. Then what we need to find out? Therefore, what is the complete integral? How to find out the complete integral? So put p equal to a and q equal to b in that equation. So this is in general ax plus by plus function of a comma b. Okay, this is the complete integral. Then this equation 1, then put p equal to ax plus by plus a square minus b square, right? See, it is a equation 2. So what is the third step? Then we need to partially differentiate this equation with respect to a and b and equate to 0. So dou z by dou a equal to x, right? This term won't come. A squared is nothing but 2a, this won't come, okay, equal to 0. Then what is a from this? X equal to minus 2a, a equal to minus x by 2, right? Okay, then what we need to do, you dou z by dou b, partially differentiate with respect to b and equate to 0. So this won't to come, then y, this term won't to come, then this term y minus 2b equate to 0. So y equal to 2b, what is b? B equal to y by 2, right? Then substitute this value in that equation 2, right? Which one? Z equal to ax. In place of a, substitute minus x by 2. Already one x, so minus x squared by 2 plus by. By is nothing but already y by 2. Y is there, so plus y squared by 2. Then what is a squared? A squared is nothing but here. Minus x by 2 the whole squared is nothing but plus x squared by 4 minus b squared. B squared is y squared by 4. So minus y squared by 4, right? We have substituted and we need to simply take LCM. 4 here minus 2x squared plus, right, plus 2y squared plus x squared minus y squared equal to z. Okay, this is the LCM. Then cross multiple, 4z equal to minus 2x squared plus x squared, we will get minus x squared, then 2y squared minus y squared plus y squared, right? Then 4z equal to y squared minus x squared, right? So this is the singular integral for this problem. So which one? 4z equal to y squared minus x squared. 4z. 4z equal to y squared minus x squared is the answer, correct answer for this type of problem. So this is the type, I'm saying again, to find out the singular integral for this type, Clairaut's term, first we need to identify which type. So type 2 will be px plus qy plus function of f of p comma q. If it is in the form, then how the complete integral will be? Complete integral will be just substitute p equal to a and q equal to b in that equation to find out the, then we need to find out the singular integral. To find out the singular integral, what we need to do, we need to partially differentiate with respect to a and b and equate to 0 and find out the value and substitute in that equation. Okay, this is, then we can find the singular solution. So this is the way to solve the problem. So in this type, we have seen three problems we have solved in this type. So for this type 2, how to find out the complete integral? We know that for complete integral is very simple. See, what we need to do, first we need to identify the type and Clairaut's form. If it is type 2, just put a p equal to a and q equal to b, it is enough. Up to second step enough, we will find the complete solution for this type. So it is very simple. To find out this singular integral only, we need to go for a third step. So we will find out this. There is a possibility to stop. We will stop up to the second step itself to find out the complete integral. So the complete integral of z equal to px plus qy square root of 1 plus p squared plus q squared. Okay. So what is given? Z equal to px plus qy plus square root of 1 plus p squared plus q squared. So t is in the type of px plus qy. Z equal to px plus qy plus function of p comma q. This is Clairaut's form. Type 2 Clairaut's form, right? Form type 2, right? Then what is the complete integral? Therefore, complete integral is, put p equal to, integral is z equal to, ax plus by plus function of a comma b, right? Then in this equation, in this given equation, say equation 1, in equation 1, put p equal to a and q equal to b, we can find out the complete solution. So ax plus by plus square root of 1 plus a squared plus b squared, right? Simple. So this is the complete integral. If they ask to find out the singular integral, means we need to differentiate partially with respect to a and b and equate to 0 and find out the value and substitute in this equation. Okay, so what we need to find out in this problem, the complete integral itself. So ax plus by plus square root of 1 plus a square plus b square. So which one? Option 3 is the right option for this problem. We'll see one more problem to find out the complete integral. It is very simple, right? So find the complete integral of px plus qy minus z the whole squared equal to 1 plus p squared plus q squared is. We need to find out the complete integral. First of all, what is given? Px plus qy minus z the whole squared equal to 1 plus p squared plus q squared. So what we need to do, see, identify the type. So first we need to, it is in the form of, find out z equal to px plus qy plus function of pq form. So taking square root on both sides, what we'll get? Px plus qy minus z, this power of 2 will go to that side as 1 by 2, 1 plus p square plus q square plus or minus square root of. Okay, then what is z? This minus z go to that side, that in this RHS will come to the LHS. So z equal to px plus qy plus or minus square root of 1 plus p square plus q square. So see, it is in the form of z is equal to px plus qy plus function of pq. So this is type 2 Clairaut's form. So, okay, therefore, what is the complete integral? Complete integral is z is equal to ax plus by. See, this is equation 1. By plus function of a comma b. Right? Then, put p equal to a and q equal to b in that equation. We will find out the answer. So, which one? Z is equal to, in this equation, ax plus by plus or minus square root of 1 plus a square plus b square. Okay, so this is the answer, complete solution or complete integral. Z is equal to ax plus by plus or minus square root of 1 plus a square plus b square. Which one? See, z is equal to ax plus by plus or minus this one. Option 1 is the right option for this problem. We will end up the session. Okay, up to this, we will stop up to this and we will solve rest of the types in our upcoming videos. Kindly subscribe our channel Off Campus and click on the bell icon. You will receive notifications as and when we upload videos. Thank you.